name is Jaspreet Singh, and today in Drupal Camp Pune, I'm welcoming you. And today my session is the case study. Today my session is the case study how we automate the test for the multiple Drupal sites using the single script. So it means that how the context came up behind this idea. So if we have the number of websites, then it would be very difficult for you in order to test all the websites in a quick time, because it will take a lot of effort. So this is a solution how to automate multiple websites within a single script. So my name is Jaspreet Singh, and I have 9+ of experience in manual and automation testing. And I have worked on the BHAT automation in multiple projects. And I also worked on the mobile native application testing. Apart from that, I've written a series of blogs on the API testing with the Postman. I'm already experiencing the working in the Agile. And apart from that, there is a lot of things which I've already recovered, discovered in the Drupal security testing. And recently, I've already delivered a webinar on the XSS as well. And active blogger as well. You can also check my blogs on the excellent.com website. So what's the agenda on this session? First one is the what and why BHAT we are using. Second one is what's the steps for the BHAT setups. Third one is the Gherkin syntax and how it is using in our BHAT scripts. Difference between the gout and the Selenium drivers. Problem statement, why we have implemented this, and what are the solutions in order to resolve this kind of problems. And I'll also show you the demonstration on the things as well, like how within a single script, the multiple sites can be tested. At the last, the key takeaways will be there. The first thing is that BHAT, what and why. So first thing which comes out is BDD PHP framework. BHAT is a kind of open source behavior driven development tool, and it supports the PHP language as well. And with the help of BDD tool, you can also deliver the software with the relevant communication, relevant adequates as well. And in terms of testing side, you'll be able to see that it also helps in acceptance, functional, as well as the regression testing as well. Second one, the Cucumber. Cucumber is also relates to the BDD, behavior driven development. It also uses the Gherkin language. Similar, the strategy has been followed by the Cucumber as well as the BHAT. Third one, validate business use cases. So why we have used the validate business use cases here? Because we had concentrated more on the business cases. That's why we have added this point. Verification and the validation. The first thing, verification, we need to verify the things are working according to the requirement. We can also check based upon the documentation check, code checks, and other things. On another hand, the validations, in which we'll check it out, like we are validating the software as per the things or not. Gherkin is an important part of this thing, which is BHAT, which BHAT and Cucumber, we both are using the Gherkin. In our further slides, I'll elaborate you why we are using the Gherkin, how it has been implemented in the BHAT. What are the syntax, those will be elaborated in my further slides. Automated test cases. Why we have added this point? Because the good test cases are those which are used in the frequent manner, and in order to reduce the bugs and other things. But if we can automate those manual test cases into the automation, then it would be helpful. So BHAT is the thing or the platform which helpful to automate the test cases, and it also help to do the acceptance, functional, as well as the regression test. Various extensions. In the BHAT, there are a lot of extensions that have been used. Few of them are Mink extension, Drupal extension. In this presentation, I'll show you the Mink extension, how it is using. There are other extensions as well, Web API extension, and many others. Okay. Prerequisites. There are 4 prerequisites are there. Before working on the BHAT, you're supposed to take care of these things are already set up and installed on your system. First one is Apache server should be there. Second one is MySQL should be there because it should not throw any sort of error. Third one, PHP should be installed with the relevant version. The fourth one is the Composer system-wide installation. If you will do the system-wide installation, that would be helpful because whenever you will execute the command Composer install or update, so it will be automatically be executed in any specific directory or the folder. Okay. How to set up the BHAG for the Drupal? This is a very important slide in order to understand the how the BHAG will be set up on our system. First thing, create a directory. For example, let's suppose you have created a directory called test in your specific folder, and then after create the list of dependencies in the Composer JSON. In my next slide, you will see the dependency of the Composer JSON. I'll elaborate you each and everything in there. When the Composer JSON have been set up and added in the root directory, then you supposed to install the you supposed to execute the command Composer install. It will all install all the dependencies in your system. Configure bhag.yml. Bhag.yml will be placed on the root directory, and there are a lot of things covered up under the bhag.yml, and I'll elaborate in my further slide what are the things covered up under the bhag.yml. Initialize bhag. In order to initialize bhag, you will execute the command bin slash bhag hyphen hyphen init, and then after the outcomes will appear. I'll show you the outcomes how it will appear. So in my further slides as well. Verify your installation. How you will be able to verify the installation? The first thing is that just execute the command bin slash bhag hyphen dl. This is the command. If you will get the predefined functions, then it means your installation process is working properly. If you are not getting the predefined functions, then you are supposed to cross-check the installation and also check the dependency in the Composer JSON. See the list of predefined steps functions, so which I have already explained so far. This is the Composer JSON file. Please make sure that while adding the Composer JSON in your root directory, the versions should be compatible to each other. For example, in the line number 3, I've added the bhag version as a 3.0 initiative, and the based upon the bhag version, you're supposed to add the relevant dependencies based upon the bhag version. So then after it will be executed. In the line number 15, I have added the one extension. It's a kind of HTML formatter, and I'll elaborate in my further slides. bhag.yml. How and why we are using the bhag.yml? Let me explain that. The first thing is the context which needs to be defined under the context. You can see that I have defined the context, main context. And the main context library will be set up, and it will show you the inbuilt functions of the main context. Filters on the line number 7, you will be able to see that I have added the tags as a test 1, test 2, test 3, test 4. Why we are using the tags, I'll show you in the demonstration, where you're supposed to add the tags on the top of the feature file. Then after, if you want to execute the any specific tag feature file, then it will only execute only one feature file based upon the tag which you have already defined in the CLI command. Line number 12, the formatters. If you have executed your script and how you will be able to find out the results, this is the output of the HTML reports. You're supposed to mention the output path of the HTML files, and it has been added on the line number 11. Then after on the line number 12, I have added the extensions. Right now I have added only one extension as a bhag mink extension, and Selenium 2 server has been used. Browser Chrome has been used. In order to elaborate more in terms of capability of the Selenium, we have added on the line number 22, in which you specify the version, browser name, and other things in terms of Selenium server. On the line number 23, I've added the files underscore path. Why we have added that? Because if you have one scenario where you're supposed to upload a one file, whether it's a JPEG, PNG, or PDF, then you're supposed to specify the path I have added the only static text test path, which is a test underscore image. So it means that I have added only one image for the demonstration. So that's why we added that. In case you have the number of files in the folder, then you can specify only the path.base. Line number 24. This is the extension for the HTML formatter. It will show you the reports of in terms of HTML. On the line number 25, the name of the file which you want to place. On the line number 26, the renderer. We can add the multiple render with the comma separated, and we should add those renders which are accepted by Behat. Line number 27, there's a print arguments. If you have added as a true, then it will show you all the tables in the report directory. In the HTML report, if you will add as a false, then it will not show you the tables. On the last slide, I'll show you how many tables and the reports are showing in the HTML. Print arguments. Basically, in terms of line number 28, we have added the print output and the true. So it means we have already updated that. Like we really need to show all the structure of the Behat. The HTML report. In the loop break, we need to elaborate all each and everything in terms of loop breaking. So we have added as a tool. I'll show you the HTML report at the end of the slide. Behat initialization. This is the very easiest way in order to do our Behat initialization. You need to add the bin slash Behat hyphen hyphen init. Then it will execute it accordingly, and the outcome should be this. If you are not getting this kind of output, then you need to cross-check whether your installation process has been done properly or not. Behat directory. You need to understand what is the directory structure should be there, so that you, if you are installing the Behat first time, then you need to take care this kind of structure should be there. So then after the process will be further move accordingly. First thing is bin folder. When you execute the command composer json install, composer install, then it will set up the directory as a bin plus the vendor directory. And if you will initialize the Behat, then it will create a directory called features. Under that feature, there will be the bootstrap folder. Then after the feature context.php. Let me first talk about these feature files, which I've already created under the feature directory, which is a create.p.feature, bedit.feature. So it means if you are creating a feature files, then you need to add the .feature extension with every feature file. When I said the feature file, it would be the scenario. And on the under the bootstrap folder, there is a feature context.php. It means you need to extend the feature context file. I'll show you in my upcoming slide how to extend the feature context. Then after, your predefined function will work accordingly. Results folder. If after the execution of script, you need to get the relevant results, then in which form you want to show the results. For example, you have the 300 websites, and how you will be able to identify out of 300 website, our first report is in which name? So you need to identify the Behat. I have added as a Behat site 1.html. How this has been added, I'll elaborate even further. And then after the test file, in which you can add multiple files which you want to upload in terms of scenario. And in that test file, I've added the one PNG file, which is test.png, and it has been used in my upload feature file. Then after the vendor folder, this will come up after installing the composer. Then after the behat.yml will be set up on the root directory, composer JSON will be set up under the root directory. The last two files are the most important part of the session, which is the run behat.php and the sites.csv. Let's talk about further on same as well. Let's understand first what is feature file, why we are using, how it has been used within the Gherkin syntax. first one, I have already shown you the tags. If you have 10 feature files and you have specified tags on the top for every feature file. So it means test 1 to test 10, we have already added for the 10 feature files. Then if you want to execute only a single feature file, then you need to execute the test 1 under the CLI command. Then it will execute only a one feature file. Second one is the feature. You need to elaborate the context of this feature. The feature we have added as a Gherkin syntax. This background is a part of Gherkin syntax. Where, why we have used the background? If we have the number of scenarios and we want to, we have a one login scenario which we are using for every scenario, then you need to add the background, add the login scenario in the background. It will execute this scenario after before every execution of scenario. For example, if I want to execute this scenario, before that it will automatically execute this one in terms of background. Given, when, and, then, but. So these are the Gherkin syntax and it's in the readable form. How to extend the feature context file? This directory will place under, this file will place under the bootstrap directory. Bootstrap directory will place under the features folder. And you need to extend the raw Drupal context. Based upon the requirement, you can change anything as well. So I have added as a raw Drupal context. So after added that function, after I extended under the feature context.php, then you execute the command bin slash bad hyphen dl. Then it will show you the list of predefined functions which has been added under the, after extending under the raw Drupal context. And this feature context file we are using for custom functions as well. For example, there are in-bit files as well. We are not able to, this is a bad practice in order to update the in-built feature files, in-built files as well. So in order to update or make new custom function, you need to update under the feature context file. Gout versus Selenium 2. Right now we are using the Selenium 2 server. I'll show you in the demonstration as well. So in the, what is the difference in between both of that? There's a lot of features files, features are there, and but only difference is that Selenium 2 won't be able to handle the HTTP basic auth, response headers, status codes. So only these things are there in terms of where we are using the APIs or something. Rest of all the things are already added, already handled by the Selenium 2 server. Yeah, let's discuss what's the difference between the JavaScript and the non-JavaScript based scenario. On the scenario one, you will see that this is a simple scenario where we are just visiting on the page, filling up the title, filling up the body, and just click on the save button. It's just a simple scenario where we do not need any JavaScript execution. If we're on the next screenshot, you will see that we have added the JavaScript tag. So it determines that this is the JavaScript scenario. Why we have added that? So you can see that. And I wait for the AJAX to finish. So it means we are just, there is a need of some JavaScript. So that's why we have added that tag. So in case, sometimes there is a one scenario where we need to wait for the jQuery. Then after the button should be submitted. So in that case, we need to add the JavaScript. Then after that function will work. Else that will throw you an error. Problem statement, why we have added, why we implemented this. The first thing, client was upgrading from Acquia Cloud Site Factory to SaaS to PaaS, which is server as a support to, software as a services.
Platform
as a services, sorry. And second one is the Drupal core updates. In manual efforts, I'll tell you an example. If one QA people have tested 10 websites in Drupal version 8, then after Drupal core have been updated from 8 point something, 8 to 8 point something, then that QA people again need to test all the 10 websites, because that is a cumbersome task in order to test all the 10 websites again. So that's why we have implemented this solution. lab example, the more than 300 websites had to be tested. So when we have a scenario, in my case, I had a scenario where I was supposed to test 100 websites. So that was very cumbersome task in order to test that. A lot of efforts would be needed. So that's why we have implemented a one solution also. Manual PA nightmare in terms of resources, number of days. When we have 300 websites, so it means our tester is testing. Let's suppose our tester is testing one website in a day. So it means we need 300 days in order to test all these 300 websites. So human efforts are a lot. In case there is a smoke testing, sanity, regression testing are there, then the efforts would be increased. So it means we have been increased our scope from one more than a 1 year. So it won't be possible for us, and it won't be allowed by the client as well, in order to spend 300 days, more than 300 days, in order to test this website. Here's the solution. First thing is that we need to prepare a one sites.csv in which we need to feed all the URLs. Prepare a one sites.csv and just add the URLs in that. I'll show you what is the sequence of that sites.csv. Then after, there is a one PHP script which iterates through the list. PHP script, what it will do, like it will just check the CSV and just cross-check the rows one by one. And it will execute all the 300 websites in a one go. Run behat per sites and generate the reports. You just need to execute only one command in order to test all the 300 websites. And then after, it will show you all the reports in HTML format with the accurate graphs as well. Let me show you the demonstration as well. So first thing is that you need to run the Selenium server with the help of command java-jar. So when it will show you this kind of output, so it means that your Selenium server is running. Just executed one single feature file, a single PHP file, which is run behat.php. After the demonstration, I'll show you what are the things we have already written in the run.php. So what it will do, it will open up the browser one by one. For example, you have added. in this after the execution of the script, it will automatically execute the scenarios one by one, and it will open up one. Please check it out the URL as well. dev-behead-side2.pentheon-side.py. So after I have added the three URLs in the side.csv. So first scenario has been completed. So it means first execution has been done for the one site. Then after that, it will automatically open another window for the second browser. This is the second site. You can check the website, which is dev-behead-side2.pentheon-side.py. This is the second site. You can add various scenario or the different scenarios in each and every feature file. Second site has been tested. So it will open up the third browser, third window for the third website. Basically, the scenario is that after executing the run-behead.php file, so when it will be completed, because unfortunately the third browser doesn't open due to the browser issue. When we execute the run behead.php file, so it will automatically test each and every website in the browser. I've used the Selenium server. Why? Because in order to show you how it is working, I can also execute this process with the headless browser as well. So, but in order to give you a demo, I show you with the Selenium server. So it will open up each and every website in the browser and execute that. How it is working, let me go through one by one process, then after we can move on. First one is the Selenium server. In order to execute the command, you need to have the one Selenium jar file. Second thing is that you need to execute the command java-jar with the Selenium server, and you will get this kind of output. So if this is out, this output is coming on your system or on the CLI, then it means the server is running, the Selenium server is running. Second thing, site.csv file, which is a major contribution on this this session, which is that in the line number one, you will see that I have added the behead site one, then after the site URL. If you have the number of websites, the, for example, 300 websites, then you need to add the one tag. You can treat it as a tag, like behead site one. So when the you will get the HTML resource, then the output or the file name will be based upon behead site one.html. So you will get to know that for the first website we have this HTML report, for the second we have this HTML report. Simple yet powerful script that runs our website. So on the line number four, we have added a one function. This is a simple file. The file handle is called fopen. It will open up. What it will do, like it will open up the sites.csv. So I have already given a one static path for my sites.csv file. So on the line number 10, it will check each and every row in the CSV file. On the next, generate the JSON parameters. So after the execution of that process, it will create the JSON parameters. I have used the line number 21 as the EMUSE BH-HTML formatter extension. Then after it will save under the parents variable, then after encode the JSON, then after export the file into the HTML file, HTML format. So this is the scenario one, what we have already written. Like we have already checked before in our first slide, in the previous slide, which is the test tag is there. You can execute with the help of test tag as well, and it will execute only scenario one. And this is a simple file, and in the second file, the scenario feature file, you can see down the line number 16, I've added one scenario for the uploading the file into this. So this is the difference which I've shown you in the both scenarios. Okay. Setting up the directory. So you can see on the results folder, we have the list of HTML reports. So after execution of script, there would be the list of HTML reports will come up, and you can use that. In our further slide, I'll show you what is the structure of HTML report, what are the graphs we are using, or what we have. So let me show you. Extension. In order to install the extension, in order to get the HTML reports, you need to run this command, which is composer require emuse slash bhat hyphen HTML format. So in order to execute that, it will install all the dependencies in the composer of JSON. Then after, you need to add your inputs in bhat.yml. Then after, this extension will work accordingly. This is the sample report which I just shown you. Let me also show you the exact report, exact file, how it is appearing on the browser. On the start, this is the HTML report. You can see the local path of my file, which is bhat site1.html, and the login and the create bhat file. Let me expand it as well. So this is scenario one, which we have used with the tag test one. It will also show you whether it's passing or failing. This is the second scenario which we have tested. This is the third scenario. And at the end, it will show you the graphs as well. Graphs is not loading, which I've just shown you on the presentation. Yeah. On this, you can see which one are passed or which one are failed. It's a hyperlink button. So when you will click on pass, right now it all tests are passed, so that's why it is showing all the results passed. This is a neat and beautiful HTML report for each and every website. So this is the results and report, consistent results. If we have the list of websites in order to test that, then we will get the consistent results in terms of automation script. But if we test it the manual efforts, then it could take a lot of time, lot of efforts. So results could vary as well in terms of manual page. But in terms of automation page, but it will give you consistent results for all the websites. this is a slide, just giving a reference example for how to create an admin user and with the help of, in ACSF, how to create an administrator role user. Just a reference which I show you. Key takeaways. The first thing is that automated test via Behat for Drupal project. So, yes, in order to execute multiple websites, in order to have the multiple websites, and we need to test it automation with the help of automation, then Behat is the concept where we can execute only one command, we can test all the websites. Handle Ajax and JS based scenario using the Selenium driver. We have already given you a demonstration on the same as well. Configuration of Behat.yml with the multiple sites. Creation of PHP script to feed the multiple URLs. You need to create a sites.csv in order to have the multiple URLs and test it accordingly. Generate the readable reports as per the site. For the single slide, site, you need to have, you will have the HTML reports in the neat and beautiful way. These are the references which I have added at the last. This is the Q&A. I have written a similar blog on this session as well, and there is the gist is also available as well. The code is also available, so you can visit on the exilent.com website, and you can have the blog. In order to reach out to me, in case of the Twitter, you can reach out to me. Thank you so much. So if you have any questions, then please.
Is there any upper limit on the number of websites you can test?
Yeah, I just
realized
any more website, you just need to include those websites in the site.csv and test it accordingly. Please make sure the scenarios should be written proper, and the URLs plus the HTML report tags should be proper in the site.csv.
For writing custom, suppose I want to write some custom stuff in the behind. To write with some custom context in the behind.
Custom context.
In behind. Suppose I have scenario to write the some custom scenario. So you are given the file upload wala scenario, right? So I want some different scenario. So I want to do some customization rather than using behind one.
You can just write down the Behat scenarios in the feature files. If you, when you set the custom function, that would be like you are saying one file would have the different scenarios, second file would have the different scenarios. Am I correct here? In order to create the custom functions, you need to go ahead with the feature context.php where you can write down the custom functions. Those will be able to working within the feature files which you have already written so far.
For that, we have to use the PHP, or we have to write some jQuery
stuff. Simple PHP functions are there, and those are not so much difficult. It's very easy to return and easy to handle. There are a lot of examples out there, so you can find them.
In prerequisite, you have mentioned that we require MySQL. So any other database is fine, right? For example, like PostgreSQL.
I'm not much sure on say, but it is possible. But right now I'm just dealing with PHP plus the MySQL, so that's why.
So basically, what we do is we use the stack.
Okay.
So what I would say is, since you know you say that I use one state, most of the critical features on I. Okay, do not test the or do not execute the entire test automation test suite on I, because anyways it's going to give false results. So execute the most critical features on I and the rest of the features on I. And that should be a success. Or maybe you would like to increase the time on only for I. That's possibly using tags. Yeah, so you can tag your feature file, and there's something also called as tag hooks in Python. So maybe possibly you can use that where the timeout is increased only for I.